Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm showing you guys how I did these flat knotless braids. So I saw this one video. I'll pop like a screenshot of her video somewhere in the video. I'll also leave a link down below, but I'm pretty sure you guys have seen this. So this is the first video that I saw doing this extra flat knotless method. And of course, y'all know I had to try it out. So that's what this video is about. I wasn't going to film it, but I figured you guys might want to see how I did it, since I will be recording a few more videos with me having this style. So yeah, really aren't a lot of videos showcasing this particular method. It's not anything extraordinary, but I really like how it came out. And as far as my braiding hair, I did use 2 packs of the Spectra, the pre-stretch braiding hair. So this is what I have left over. So I use like just under 2 packs of hair. So like I said, that pretty much covers everything. We're gonna go ahead and get into the quick like demo tutorial. Hopefully the angles are pretty good. I can't really see what I was doing from this particular angle, but this was the best setup that I have for right now. So yeah, hopefully the video is helpful. Again, like I said, leave me comments down below if there was anything that I missed, and I will see you guys in my next video. So I'm going in with my edge control first so that I can put this on my hair. My braids do get a bit thinner as I braid further down. If that's something that you don't like, of course you can just keep adding braiding hair to keep it even throughout, but me personally, I don't mind it getting a bit thinner in the end. So this is what the braid is looking like. Of course, I think it takes like some practice, and especially doing it this way, it can be a bit difficult to keep the braid even throughout so that it doesn't have any lumps or anything. But since the braid is quite small, you can't really tell where that hair was added in it. So what I'm going to do now is put my hair in one big braid to the back and dip my ends in some hot water just so I can get that crimped or wave effect. And after that, I will be back once my hair is dry. I'm just gonna blow dry it just for a little bit so that my hair isn't dripping wet. And then I'll come back and show you guys what it looks like. But it's pretty much just going to look like this because my ears have already been dipped in hot water. But I kind of want it to be more of a deeper wave. So I'm gonna do one big braid and see if that gives me the look that I'm going for.